It's been about 25 years. Rocky's best-selling book, Somebody Up There Likes Him, came out 25 years ago, talking about how fast time can go. His new book is called Somebody Down Here Likes Me Too, and it's true. Rocky Graziano probably has as many friends as anyone I know. Wouldn't you say?
Oh, yeah.
He's got friends from all walks of life. And if you've never seen Rocky Graziano fight when he was at his prime, you've missed one of the really tough fighters. Would you welcome Rocky Graziano?
Great, Johnny. Yeah. Really great.
You know, I hope you're not going to tell me tonight, because I saw that fight with Joe Frazier the other night. Or was who was the guy he fought? I can't even think of his name.
Fought,
you can't either, but...
Melton May.
No, it wasn't Melton May. Tough young guy.
He fought a young kid. I forgot his name, but...
Jumbo Cumming, you're right.
And he shouldn't have... That guy's a tough guy. I'm surprised that Frazier...
Got in the ring?
Won the fight. Yeah. I mean,
he's 38 years old, Frazier. Now, Ali is coming back and going to fight in Puerto Rico now.
Well, I don't like those guys. Muhammad Ali is a hell of a... I don't like them to fight. I mean, Muhammad Ali is one hell of a guy.
Yeah.
He's a nice guy, a gentleman. I love him. I love Joe Frazier. And I think they shouldn't fight. I swear they shouldn't fight. It's a shame. Even if they need money or need money, I don't know what it is about, but they...
Yeah.
Shouldn't fight.
Because you can't get hurt at that age, can't you?
When you're old, you can't. Like he am. I hit him a shot in the El Morocco the other day. And he thought everybody had to hit me with a hook.
Do guys still come up to you when you're out? I run into you every time I'm in New York.
Yes.
I see you around Third Avenue or something, and we go and have a beer or something.
Yeah.
Do guys still come up to you? I can't imagine anybody being that foolish.
Want to
mix it with a champion.
Very rarely, but sometimes a guy gets a little drunk.
That's what I'm talking about.
He says, you know, I think I could take you, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I says, you know, you talk worse than me.
And they back off pretty fast,
they
right?
They back off pretty good, you know, they know.
Well, it's illegal for you, anyway, to get in any kind of a fight,
well,
isn't
now
it?
Well, I'm 59 years old now, and I'm in pretty good shape, and I drink a lot of beer, you know? And that's all I do, just drink beer. I like to drink beer, and I love it. And so that's my diet. That's a diet I got. I just drink beer, I don't have to eat too much.
Yeah. You've really known him since 19?
I know him since 19, in the Neverly Country Club with all our pals. And he got in the ring with me one day, just kidding around. I mean, but then he went, like this here, and he went that way, right out of the ring. My buddy was a funny guy, and I met him, and we know each other so many.
Tony Pallone,
Al Pacino, all those guys, and Albie Goldstein, and all those guys.
And where was that guy from Cedar Willy, Washington?
The kid died. He got killed in an accident.
I didn't know that.
The nice kid.
He was light heavy. You were boxing him every day to get in shape for Jay, which the fight never came off.
Yeah. Was the Zale fight the tough one? The toughest one?
Oh, he was a tough guy. Jeez, those tough guys.
Yeah.
Especially this guy. Oh, my. He was a tough guy. I hit him. My hands were swollen like this here. I hit him with shots.
Wouldn't go down.
And he took a shot, punch that was unbelievable. And I took a pretty good punch, too. You know, both got... I went to Chicago for the book about a couple weeks ago, and I saw Tony Zale, and I saw him in the nice. I said, "Hello, Tony, how you feel?" He said, "What are you doing over here?" I says,
"Did he talk that way?"
Yeah, I said, "Yeah." I act a little voice in him.
Oh, I see.
So I said, "I'm here for a book." He says, "You had the book already." I said, "No, I got a new book coming out called Somebody Donnie Likes Me Too." He said, "Who's that?" I said, "You're going to do a book?" He says, "Are you going to mention my name in the book?" I says, "Yeah." He says, "You're going to pay me some money for the book?" I said, "I'll give you a couple of dollars." What else?
You were kind of a hellion as a kid, weren't you? You got in a few scrapes.
Well, I was in a lot of trouble. When I was 11 years old, I was in reformatory.
Yeah.
You know, I was in know, fourth grade for 9 years, you know, all that jazz, my whole life. And I didn't have too much education, you know. Annabelle was a streetwise guy. And I learned. And funny thing, Johnny, this is a real true story. I learned to get respect in a ring. You get the black guy, find a white guy, or Puerto Rico, whatever. We'll fight, we'll kill each other right. for 10 rounds. And right after the bell rings, we hug each other.
I've often noticed that in fights. That's hard to understand.
I really don't understand it either. But I learned to respect.
Yeah.
You know, which is nice. I mean, and then when I got into this show business with all these actors and Martha Ray, a beautiful woman.
Yeah, you played her boyfriend on the show, right?
Yes, Goomba.
Goomba, yeah.
And she was very, very nice to me, you know. And I liked them. They treated me nice. I treated them nice. And they always laughed when I talked, you know.
Yeah.
You know, I talk better now, you know.
Yeah. Did you ever find anybody you really didn't want to hurt? I mean, when you get in the ring,
I had a kid that I liked very good. He was a hell of a good fighter. His name was Tony Gennaro.
Yeah.
And I fought him. I fought him three times.
Yeah.
I beat him three times, but just once I knocked him out. Two 10-round decision. I always liked Tony, you know. I really didn't want to hurt him.
Yeah. Is there anybody you really, like when Joe Louis fought Schmeling, you know, the second time where he really was out, is there anybody like that that you really wanted to nail? For any personal reasons, or you didn't even have to mention any names. I just wondered if there was a particular time you wanted to go fight where you really wanted
guy,
to.
Certainly, a guy like to split his head open with an axe.
That pretty well says it.
That's in a book.
Split his head open with an axe.
And this here book I got, I just thought a couple of seconds.
It's right here.
The book is somebody doesn't like me. It's not a book about fighting. It's about all the people I met, like Johnny and the whole gang of them and the whole bunch of us over here, Buddy and everybody. You know.
You met work with President Reagan?
President Reagan and all of them, and Errol Flynn and Martha Ray and Edward G. Robinson. Edward G. Robinson. So I was down.
Hold the story. Let me do this commercial. Then come back. Tell me about it, because that's a funny story about him wanting to meet some certain people.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll do that. I know. I've read the book. Yeah. We'll be right back. Robinson, who played in his career many great roles, but was remembered for the tough guy roles, Little Caesar and so forth. And what did he want you to do once?
Well, I saw this guy, you know, on a show. While we were doing a show, the Martha Ray show.
Right.
And I, a little guy. You know, and it wasn't that too little. It was almost about as big as me. And he says, Rocky, you know, I'd like to speak to you. He didn't speak the same way as he did on the screen. Different, you know. Nice. He spoke like nice. He always, like, almost to me like a sissy, like, you know.
Right.
Hello. Hello.
Do that again. What was that?
Hello.
How are you?
Agnew D. Robinson. And he said he wants me to go down and show me, you know, downtown and Mulberry Street and things. He says, and see some real tough guys, you know.
He wanted to meet some tough guys.
Some tough guys. So I says, come on down. I see, you know. So I said, I'll bring it down. We'll go down to eat. So I went downtown to an Italian restaurant. All the men were there, all the guys over there. And he was looking like it. They all look the same as me, as everybody, and they all look tough.
Yeah.
But they wasn't. They were, one was a guy was a lawyer, one guy was one guy, and all the, and I brought him, and he was so happy. He thought they were really wise gangsters, you mean?
Yeah.
But they wasn't. One was a lawyer, one was a judge.
Now, a moment ago, when you started to talk like that, and you says, hello, how are you?
Yeah.
Did you ever take any... elocution, any speech lessons?
When Reagan was doing a bid with the Miami Undercover, he told me if I become president, I'm going to make him my elocution teacher.
Is that what
No, but the guy, when I see a guy come, this author of the book, his name is Ralph Corsell.
Yeah.
When he come to me, he says, Rocky, he says, I'm going to do a book on you. Somebody down here likes me too. I said, that book was done already. Get the hell out of here. What do you want to do a book like that for? I know this guy all my life. I said, what do I want to do? So I know Ralph Corsell all my life. So he says, I've been with you for the last 10 years. He says, I got this little tape machine with me.
And that's the way he did the book.
He's been taping me for years, for 3 or 4 years. He put everything together, got the book, and God bless him, we're doing
it. How's it doing? Is it selling pretty good?
We sold out in New York.
Yeah. How do you spend your time now? What do you do besides now that the book is done?
I do a lot of commercials.
I see. You've been on for...
I do a lot of commercials all over New York.
Which ones are the toughest?
The
commercials.
They were no world. He said, I read the cards, the cue cards.
You did, yeah.
Cue cards. I told you, I was in the fourth grade for 9 years, I thought.
Yeah.
I'm not that smart. I don't read that.
You did. You've had breakfast cereal commercials?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I done maybe about 5,000 commercials.
I
go to do New York City. I just done a nice, good commercial in New York City for OTP, off-track betting. And, really, it's really good, a good commercial. Yeah. And I got 20 G's for it, you know?
Yeah.
I say two words. How you like that?
What did you say?
I said, one, I says, a big hitter in a fifth, you know?
That was it.
That's 10,000. And I just said, hello there, Eddie. Okay, another 10,000.
Another 10,000 for that. That beats getting hit in the head, doesn't it, in a ring?
I want to tell you something.
Yeah.
If I had two kids now,
yeah,
and they're young, like, you know, they're young, you know, 16, 17,
right,
and I, with the money they're making in fighting, $8 million for one fight, $5 million for one fight, they don't have to go to school.
Yeah.
Just go become a fighter.
Yeah, let me ask you this. Jim Murray, you know Jim Murray, the sports writer. Jim Murray is probably one of the best sports writers in America. And he said the other day in a show that was something on his life, that boxing is probably the only sport where two people get in and the idea is to knock the other person unconscious. Not the only sport. It happens in football, but that's not the idea. Only in boxing. He says it probably should be outlawed, and yet there's great drama in boxing, you know, because it's a one-on-one, and through history it has been high drama. But he says, and a lot of sports writers think that it should be outlawed, because it's the only sport where you go out to physically scramble another man's brains.
Good for me.
It's been a great life for you.
It helped me not to be in Sing Sing for 80 years, like, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it really helped me out. Sports, it helped me very good. It made me learn respect. Respect the black guy, a white guy, a Puerto Rican guy. Really nice. I mean, and I really respect, like, you and him. Yeah. And him, I don't know about him. He's rough.
So you say it's okay to go ahead, Fox, right?
Oh. I would really, no, because if you stay in good shape, if you stay any kind of sport, any sport besides boxing, if you stay in good shape, you can become a billionaire in any one of these sports, basketball, football, baseball, beautiful.
And there are probably as many injuries in other sports.
Sure. Hey, look at these guys getting hurt all the time.
Yeah. Okay, we'll be back. Stay where you are. I'll see you next trip to New York.
Okay, John. All right. Good.
Buddy, you open at the Riviera December the 13th, and you're going to be at the Concord Hotel the 2nd of January. First time in what, 17 years, you said?
I haven't been there 17 years.
Yeah. You'll have a ball. It's a great place to go.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for being here, buddy. Tomorrow night, we have Elizabeth Ashley, Charlie Callis, and a segment of some new foreign commercials for you. Have a nice night.